Ramone, different session today. Obviously, a lot to talk over. What was the upshot there? It sounded as though it got a little bit vociferous or boisterous there at one stage.
No, just us talking. We had a great chance of winning the other day. We let it get out of our hands. So just a dialogue between the group. Just trying to hash out a few things moving forward. We got a long season ahead of us. So the more we can talk about everything and get it together, the better we'll be on the court.
So no suggestion of people not getting along?
Nah. We're good, man. We're family, man. So we're good.
Is it refreshing to be able to speak so freely? Like, we could hear a bit of shouting, and, you know, is it refreshing to be able to have those robust conversations, but then, you know, like you said, at the end of it, you're family and you go about your business?
Yeah, I mean, it's good to sometimes get out how you feel, and that's what I think that meeting was about. We watched the film. A few guys had a conversation between each other. And we all left out there, you know, happy about it. Like I said, we got everything out. You know, we'll come back to practice, ready to go, and prepare for Sydney.
You said you had a chance to win, the game slipped away. What do you do differently this week to get back on the winners list?
Just learn from our mistakes from the last game. And then I think we're very, very focused on playing Sydney, because you know how that game went the last time. So for us, we'll be, you know, locked in this week, trying to get our preparation as best as possible. And you know, that standing is pretty tight. You know, we want to try to stay in that top four and try to get a big win Saturday.
How fired up are you mentally? I guess that first meeting against Sydney, jet lag, Jerome just being incorporated, a few things kind of going against you. How fired up are you now to get a win, get one back on them?
We'll be very fired up. I mean, they're the top team right now. That itself should give us motivation to go into the game. And then revenge. We didn't play the way we wanted to. We're not going to make no excuses. We have them at our home court. You know, we'll have that energy and getting up and in those guys. So we'll see how it goes, and hopefully we come out with the win.
What do you think you need to do better this time around against Sydney?
I mean, I won't say too much about what I feel we need to do, but I think we'll come up with a great game plan. But I think just playing harder, that's the main thing, giving our effort, the little things, rebounding, you know, all the things that we can control, and I think we'll be fine.
Eric Griffin had trouble on debut against the Kings. He fouled out again, so that's twice in five games. Do you get any concern about that, or do you need to speak to him or just keep him up, given obviously he's having a little bit of trouble adjusting?
No, I think he'll be good. Like you said, it's just an adjustment thing for him. We're all in his ear about it, just trying to play as smart as possible, because we need him on the floor as much as we can. He's great out there when we do have him, defensively and offensively. But I think he'll be fine. I mean, it's still early in the season, so he'll be good.
Who have you got your eye on for Sydney? They've got a lot of great players who will need to be shut down. Who do you think you'll match up with, and who do you want to, I guess, take out of the game?
None specifically. Like you said, I feel like they all got a lot of, you know, offensive talent on that end. I'm not sure who I'll guard yet, whoever Joey assigns me to. So, I mean, until then, I won't know until Saturday. Yeah.